What's up, y'all? You're here to better understand the hi-hat approach to Carter Beafourd of the Dave Matthews Band. And I'd like to explain to you my thoughts on how to best approach the way that he plays hi-hat in that syncopated, linear type of style and technique. Back in the 90s, Carter Beafourd put a video together called Under the Table and Drumming. And he talked a lot about his different techniques and fills of different styles. If you look across the internet, you'll see many clips of this particular video series. And one of the clips that you'll see is around his hi-hat approach, where he describes his method of playing. What I would like to do is build off of the exercise that Carter Beafourd is talking about in his video, where he's using 16th notes as an example. In this video, what we're going to do is take a 16th note pattern across a few different measures and separate it into different areas. So each measure, or I should say each quarter of a measure, we know 16th notes as 1E and a, 2E and a, 3E and a, 4E and a. And we're going to separate a hi-hat pattern into each one of those different areas of one full 16th note pattern. So let's start just by simply looking at the on beats to each pattern. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Here's how that sounds.
1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1.
Now the next in line in that pattern is the E. 1E and a, 2E and a, 3E and a. Take a look.
1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1.
Third, we have the and. 1E and a, 2E and a, 3E and a. Check it out.
1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1.
And the last part of this pattern is the 1E and a, 2E and a, 3E and a. Here's how that looks.
1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1.
So we're going to take that 16th note pattern and stretch it across an 8-bar exercise, with 2 bars going to each one of those 4 parts of a 16th note. 2 bars for 1, 2 bars for E, 2 bars for and 2 bars for a. Here's what that sounds like.
1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1.
So that gives you an idea of everything sort of just sandwiched together. Now let's take one more look at this from a more playful perspective. I'm going to keep the BPMs the way that we've kept them. I'll keep the kick on 1 and 3, the snare in 2 and 4, and I'll just dance around that beat using the hi-hat in different types of patterns. Check it out.
1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2.
What I'd like to do is show you an example of some of the ways in which Carter uses this type of thought process around some of the actual songs from the Dave Matthews Band. So check these out.
Stations, winter's cold, swing races.
Now, you may have caught something rather unique on those covers. Ghost notes on a hi-hat. What? I know, it's really strange, but this is part of the Carter Beafourd approach to hi-hat playing. He doesn't just use a hi-hat for simple timekeeping purposes. He uses the hi-hat as a part of the song, as a part of the conversation that he's having with the other musicians on stage. And as a part of those conversations, instead of just hitting the hi-hat and its accents, he uses little ghost notes in between those as well to simply just kind of keep that rhythm going. So it's something to really check out. If you go through YouTube and find some of the live videos of the band, you'll see exactly what I'm talking about in many, many different examples. So again, to start incorporating this type of hi-hat playing into your style, start with the 16th note exercise that we went through. Start at a low BPM level using a metronome and continue to gradually increase that level until you find like you're in a really good area of comfort. Once you do so, you'll start to find yourself incorporating these hi-hat patterns into songs that you play doing covers or maybe with your own band. Thanks for taking the time to check out this video. Please be sure to subscribe to my channel and get the latest updates on drum covers, solos, and other tutorials that I post out here. Thanks for watching. Why did I wave?